Hello students, welcome to the online chemistry classes of Sri Guru College. In the last class, we have started chemical kinetics, a topic from physical chemistry. We have first seen the definition of the chemical kinetics. We said that it is a branch of physical chemistry which deals with three things. The first is the rate of chemical reaction, another is the factors affecting the rate of chemical reaction, and third one is the mechanism of the chemical reaction. After the definition of chemical kinetics, we have seen its importance, that it is very important commercially. We have seen two examples, that the manufacture of ammonia, the speed of that reaction you want to deliberately increase, because ammonia is very important ingredient, component of the fertilizers. Then another example, we have seen that spoilage of food, that speed we want to decrease, because the spoilage of food, we want to increase the shelf life of food. After learning these two importance, we have learned about the rate of reaction, because that is the most central part of this chemical kinetic studies. We define rate of reaction as it is the change in concentration of reactant or product per unit time. Then we have seen the formula, that rate of reaction can be written as negative delta molar concentration of reactant divided by delta T. And why this negative sign is needed? We said it is because the molar concentration of reactant decreases with time. That delta molar concentration of reactant can be written as R2 square bracket, of course, because square bracket means molar concentration, minus R1 divided by T2 minus T1. Then we can express it in terms of product also. We have seen that both these gives us the same result. That's why we said in the definition, we can take either the change in concentration of reactant or product. We said that rate of reaction is equal to delta molar concentration of product divided by delta T. And here no need of negative sign, because product concentration go on increasing in the due course of reaction. It means product appears, we said. If we make that time interval smaller, we have some another rate, we call it as instantaneous rate, rate of reaction at particular moment, and we have to express it in the form of differential form of the rate. We can say rate of reaction is equal to negative sign d. This small d indicates the very very small decrease in the concentration of reactant in a very small difference in the time. So that rate at a particular instant, instantaneous rate and average rate, we can express graphically also. We have done that, how the graph looks like if we plot the concentration of reactant on the y-axis and time on the x-axis. The reactant concentration graph decreases, and for the product concentration it increases, and that slope of that graph gives us the rate of reaction at particular instant. But in case of reactant, that graph is having the negative slope, so we have to multiply slope with the negative sign, and for product no need of negative sign. And lastly, we have learnt about the relation units of rate of reaction. That part also we have covered. The unit is clear from the formula itself, as formula has change in concentration of reactant and product. Concentration, we have mole per liter, we call it as molarity, divided by the time required for that change, which can be either seconds, it can be minutes, or it can be hours. So mole per liter per time is the unit of rate of reaction. But for gaseous reaction, the partial pressures are involved, and the unit can be atmosphere or bar. We can use any depending on the question. So you can say atm per time is the unit for that. And then we have applied the inert gas system, PV is equal to nRT, and we said that the rate of reaction in terms of atmosphere per time is equal to mole per liter per time multiplied by R is the universal gas constant and T is the absolute temperature. So that part in the last class we have covered. Now today we'll go ahead and we'll try to classify the types of chemical reactions on the basis of their speed. We have classified the chemical reactions on the basis of different aspects. For example, we said there is a combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, double displacement reaction. This is one way to classify the chemical reaction. Another which we see in organic is substitution reaction, elimination reaction, condensation reaction. This is another way to classify the chemical reaction. According to the chemical kinetics, we can say that the types of chemical reactions according to the speed, we can classify the reaction in three different ways. One is the very fast reactions. The example of very fast reactions is the ionic reactions. The well-known example we have seen is in the conformation of the chloride radical in the qualitative analysis of the inorganic salt. If you already detected the chloride radical is present in a given salt, for example, this is NaCl, we should take the aqueous solution of it and then we add the silver nitrate into it, that also aqueous, and we get the precipitate of silver chloride and the sodium nitrate. So this reaction occurs very fast because ions are already present in the aqueous solution and there is just this rearrangement of the ions and the reaction takes place. So very fast reaction, and that's why we can say, I'm writing this rate of reaction as ROR. The rate of reaction cannot be conveniently measured. Why rate of reaction cannot be conveniently measured? Because for measurement of rate of reaction we need data, we need to different time interval, but reaction is so fast that in the given laboratory condition we may not able to trace out what is the initial concentration, what is the final concentration, because it happens in nanoseconds, 10⁻⁹ seconds. So this type of reactions do not comes under the study of the chemical kinetics because they are very fast reactions. Their rate cannot be conveniently measured. We have another type of reaction which I will write here. Very slow reactions. Very slow reactions. We know that there are many reactions which occurs at very slow rate. The example is setting of cement. It requires days to complete this reaction. This slow process, we have to cure the cement for setting, so it requires days to complete. Or say rusting of iron, which requires months to complete. Or we can say formation of coal and petroleum, which requires millions of years to complete. So these are very slow reactions because they are requiring days or months or years to complete. Again, we can comment on these reactions that rate of reaction cannot be conveniently, we'll use this word conveniently because that's how the studies are made, conveniently measured. So these very slow reactions are also not the part of our chemical kinetics because it is difficult to trace the progress of the reaction in the given laboratory setup. So that's why their study is not done in the chemical kinetics, we can say. But in between these two extremes, we have another type of reactions. We call it as moderate rate reaction, moderate rate reaction, which do not happen very fast, that is in nanoseconds, which do not happen very slow, months, years, days, like that. In between them, the reactions which occurs in minutes and hours, this moderate rate reaction, we can take the example of inversion of cane sugar or the hydrolysis, breaking in presence of water, of starch, or we can say the acid hydrolysis of methyl acetate. So these are a few examples where the rate is not very high, but not very fast or not very slow. And we can say that for these reactions, rate of reaction can be conveniently measured. So these moderate rate reactions comes under the study of chemical kinetics. There are many more examples which we'll see in the this chemical kinetics part, which we can say that they are moderate rate reactions and we can conveniently measure the rate and their studies can be done. So you have to remember at least one, two examples of all these very fast reactions, which are ionic reactions, occurs in nanoseconds, very slow reactions, requires months and years to complete, rusting of iron or formation of coal and petroleum, and these moderated reactions which are very much part of our kinetic studies, and the example being the inversion of cane sugar. So after this type of chemical reactions, remember we have classified these reactions on the basis of kinetic studies. Next part is how to express the rate of chemical reaction. We'll take two examples. You look at this example very carefully. We'll take mercury and we'll add chlorine to it, the combination reaction, and we get the chloride of mercury. If you want to express the rate of reaction, remember I am writing ROR, it is not standard abbreviation, but instead of writing always rate of reaction, I am writing this ROR means rate of reaction. This mercury being the reactant, it disappears, so I write this negative sign. This delta, which means change in, square bracket means molar concentration of mercury, divided by the time period in which this change occurs, is equal to, again this chlorine is being the reactant, it also disappears, so this negative, and this Cl2. And this is difference in time, and this is product, which is HgCl2. So it appears, and this is chloride of mercury, and this is difference in time. No need of negative sign because it is the product. These are average rates. So if you want to calculate the rate of reaction, either you should have the data regarding disappearance of mercury, or you should have data regarding disappearance of chlorine, or you can have the data regarding the appearance of chloride of mercury, and you can calculate this. This already we have seen. Now consider the another reaction. 2 moles of hydrogen iodide gives hydrogen and iodine. Now this is different reaction than the previous one. What is the difference? Here 1 mole of mercury, 1 mole of chlorine, and 1 mole of mercury chloride, which has valency of course +2. But here we have 2 moles of hydrogen iodide, which disappears and forms 1 mole of hydrogen and 1 mole of iodine. So number of moles are different. What will happen if number of moles are different? Rate of disappearance of hydrogen iodide and rate of appearance of hydrogen are not equal. So again I will write here, try to understand. Rate of disappearance, of course these are abbreviations I am using, these are not standard abbreviations, I already told you. Instead of writing rate of disappearance, I am making it short. Rate of disappearance of hydrogen iodide, and if we compare the rate of appearance of hydrogen, we can make it out that they are not equal. They are not equal. Why? Because 2 moles of hydrogen iodide disappear and 1 mole of hydrogen appears. Now we have to make them equal. Mathematically we have to say that rate of disappearance of hydrogen iodide should be equal to rate of appearance of hydrogen. We have to make it equal. How we can make it equal? When 1 mole of hydrogen appears, 2 moles of hydrogen iodide disappears. So can I write rate of disappearance of hydrogen iodide is equal to rate of appearance of hydrogen multiplied by 2? Just think over it, what I am writing here. It means when 1 mole of hydrogen appears, 2 moles of hydrogen iodide disappears. That's why I can write the rate of disappearance of hydrogen iodide reactant, which coefficient is 2, stoichiometric coefficient, is equal to rate of appearance of hydrogen, it has stoichiometric coefficient 1, multiplied by the 2. Of course we can use this in our usual notation. Rate of disappearance of hydrogen iodide, I can write it as negative delta H I divided by delta T. This is the rate of disappearance of hydrogen iodide, and this is the rate of appearance of hydrogen, and I am writing here as multiplied by 2. I can transfer this 2 to the other side, and we can write 1 by 2 negative change in molar concentration of hydrogen iodide divided by this delta T difference in time is equal to this delta H2 and this delta T. So what we have done, we have transferred this 2 to the another side. Now if we read this part, just this part, we can call it as the rate of, this is rate of disappearance of hydrogen iodide, and we are dividing this by this digit 2, and this digit 2 happens to be the stoichiometric coefficient of hydrogen iodide. You are understanding what we are doing. For this H2 and when we express it in terms of hydrogen, you can say it is divided by 1. Nothing is written, means we can write 1 by 1. It means we are dividing this rate of appearance of hydrogen by 1, which happens to be the stoichiometric coefficient of hydrogen. We can extend this and we can write this to iodine also. We can write this as Di2 by delta, and we can multiply it by again or divide this by 1. It means this 1 is the stoichiometric coefficient of this iodine. So these stoichiometric coefficients are very important when we express the rate of reaction where the stoichiometric coefficients are not equal to 1. Here they, all they were 1, 1, 1. We have not used them. But here they are, there are 2 moles of hydrogen iodide, right? And we have used that digit here, 1/2. Why we use that? Because rate of disappearance of hydrogen iodide, it's 2 times of rate of appearance of hydrogen. And that's why we have just transferred that 2 to the other side. It becomes 1/2, and we arrange this equation. So this is very important. So what I am generalizing here is very important generalization we are making to express rate of reaction where stoichiometric coefficient is not equal to 1. Stoichiometric coefficient is not equal to 1 means there are 2, 3, 4 like that. Rate of disappearance of reactant or rate of appearance of product divided by their respective, yes, we are using this word respective, for this hydrogen iodide it is 2, respective stoichiometric coefficient. So this very important statement, to express the rate of reaction where stoichiometric coefficient of reactant or product is not equal to 1, the rate of disappearance of reactant or rate of appearance of product, it should be divided by the respective stoichiometric coefficient of that reactant or the product. So this is very important statement, and we have to use it in various equations. I will write one equation which precisely given in our NCERT textbook, and you try to write the rate of reaction expression using that. I will write this reaction which I said just now, which is given. A bromide ion in aqueous state, bromate ion in aqueous state, and this is in acidic medium, and it forms bromine and H2O in liquid state. Of course, physical states not much matter when we express the rate. The reaction is not balanced, but we can balance this by oxidation number method, which already you are learning redox reaction. The oxidation number here is negative 1, here it is. Oxygen is negative 2, 3 oxygens are there. It means it needs 6 electrons. 1 electron is already there, so it means 5 electrons it needs. This is molecular state, so this is 0 oxidation state. The changes in oxidation number, if we look into the reactant and product, the 5 electron and 1 electron, it means there is change of 6 oxidation number here. 5 plus 5 and negative 1, total 6 is there. So we can make this 6 by writing this 3 here, because 1 bromine is 1, but there are 3 into 2, 6 bromines are there. So there are 6 bromine. We will not write, now we have to make balance the bromine, but we will not write here 5, because again oxygen has to change. So I will write here 5. Bromines are balanced, oxygens are 3. I will write here 3H2O, and we can say that it is 6H+. The atoms are already balanced, charges are also balanced because it is negative 5 and 1 negative, which is negative 6, and it is 6 positive, which ultimately leads to the zero charge. So the equation is balanced. Now see how we can express the rate of reaction where stoichiometric coefficient is not equal to 1. Rate of disappearance of reactant, rate of appearance of product has to be divided by their respective stoichiometric coefficients. So I will write rate of reaction is equal to, the stoichiometric coefficient is 5, so I will multiply it by 1 by 5, means I am dividing it by 5, and then I will write in the bracket the negative sign. This delta we are negative, this delta t, I will make this better, this type of bracket to distinguish between this square bracket and like this. And then stoichiometric coefficient is 1, so I can write it as delta molar concentration of bromide ion, bromate ion, sorry, and difference in time, then it is 1 by 6, and this disappears, and this is 1 by 3, and this is dH2O by dt. So like that we can make. So this is the way in which we can express this rate of reaction. Now what is the difference if we consider this, how to read this, because this is very important principle numerical. The rate of reaction is equal to rate of disappearance of bromide ion divided by 5. If I just put out this 1 by 5, how to read this? This is rate of disappearance of bromide ion, but it is not equal to rate of reaction. Then when they are equal when rate of disappearance of bromide ion should be divided by 5, then that becomes equal to rate of reaction. So when stoichiometric coefficient is not equal to 1, there is difference in the rate of reaction and the rate of disappearance of the reactant. If stoichiometric coefficient is 1, we can say rate of reaction is equal to rate of disappearance of bromate ion. But when stoichiometric coefficient is 5, we should say rate of reaction is equal to rate of disappearance of bromide ion divided by 5. What is the relation between these two rate of appearances? We can transfer this 3 here, this 3 we can cancel, and we can say that rate of appearance of bromine is equal to rate of appearance of H2. We can do it mathematically, that's why these numbers are useful there, because they exactly expresses how the rates are to be written. So we can just transfer this 3, 3, 3, we can cancel, and both rates are equal. We can make it out from equation also, because stoichiometric coefficient of this bromine is 3, stoichiometric coefficient of this H2O is 3. It means the rate of appearance of bromine is equal to rate of appearance of H2O. But whether rate of appearance of bromine is equal to rate of reaction, we should say no. Rate of reaction is equal to rate of appearance of bromine divided by 3. Like that. So there is difference between the rate of reaction and rate of appearances and disappearances. They are equal mathematically only when stoichiometric coefficient is 1. If stoichiometric coefficient is not equal to 1, rate of reaction is equal to rate of either appearance of product or rate of disappearance of reactant, that doesn't matter. It should be divided by their respective stoichiometric coefficient. So this is a very important concept. There are many questions asked in MCQs also, in board exam also, theory exam also. So we have to solve some numerical questions, whatever part we have learned till now, we can solve some questions regarding this, and these concepts will be more clear. So I have brought some numerical questions here. There are many questions in the NCERT textbook. Some are solved examples, some are in-test questions. All these questions are important. Along with that, some other questions also we'll try to solve. So we'll start with these questions. Question number one, I'll write here, that there is one reaction given, 2A plus B yields 3C. This is the reaction. The rate of appearance of C, the rate of appearance of C at time t is 1.3 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per second. Calculate two part we have to calculate. First is the rate of reaction, and another is the rate of disappearance of A. A is the reactant. So you can easily solve this question. You can pause this video and you can solve yourself, because it's not much complicated question. We already know how to use this data. So one equation is given. Rate of appearance of C is given. Why we say appearance? Because C is the product. And this is the value they have given. Look at the unit, mole per liter per second, means actually rate is given for it. And then rate of reaction they have been asked. So we can use this equation, 2A plus B gives 3 plus C. And we can write rate of reaction is equal to 1 by 2 negative sign delta A by delta T is equal to, yes, 1 by 2 I have written, because 2 is the stoichiometric coefficient, so I have divided the rate of disappearance by 2. Rate of disappearance of B, negative sign I have to write, and that equals to 1 by 3 rate of appearance of C. Now rate of appearance of C is given, means they are given delta C by delta T. So we can say given term here is delta C by delta T is given, because that is exactly the rate of appearance of the product C here. That is equal to 1.3 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per second. Now they have asked us to calculate the rate of reaction. We can calculate this now, because we know the relation between rate of reaction and rate of appearance of C. That relation is quite clear from this expression we have written. It is 1 by 3, and this is in bracket, we call it as rate of appearance of C, and that is equal to 1 by 3, and this value they have already given, 1.3 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 4. We can just rearrange this, we can write this as 13 into 10 raised to minus 5 by 3. 3 4s are 12, so we can write 4 point, remaining is 1, so we can write it as 0.33 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 5, and you can write this as mole per liter per second. So rate of reaction is not equal to rate of appearance of C, but rate of reaction is equal to rate of appearance of C divided by 3. So this first part we have answered. Rate of reaction is this much. We have to calculate correct quantity, and we have to write the appropriate unit, which is mole per liter per second. Why same unit? Because this is just number 1 by 3, and this delta C by delta T has unit mole per liter per second, which is the rate of unit of rate of reaction. Now, rate of appearance of A also they have asked. So, how they are rate of disappearance of A is related to rate of reaction. Transfer this 2 here. Already you got rate of reaction. 2 times of rate of reaction. This you can do. Or you just transfer this 2 to this side. Because you know this term. B is not mentioned. So leave it. That is not required. So 2 can be transferred here. And we can write 2 by 3. Rate of appearance of C. We can use anyway. You will get same answer. But I'll write like this. Rate of disappearance of A. Rate of disappearance of A is nothing but negative delta A by delta T is equal to, I am transferring these 2 here, I am using the data of rate of appearance of C because that is given, so we will better use that. Alternative way also I have told you, alternate way is you can use the rate of reaction which you have just calculated in step A. Rate of disappearance of A is nothing but 2 into rate of reaction, that also you can do, but we are using that data, so it is equal to 2 by 3 dc by dt, it is 2 by 3 dc by dt rate of appearance of C already we have, which is 1.3 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 4, we can write this as 2.6, this 2 into 1.3 divided by 3 into 10 raised to minus 4, which is nothing but, again we can write this as 26 into 10 raised to minus 5 divided by 3, and 3 8s are 24, so we can write this as 8, then 2 remains, and again we can write it as point, and if it is 20 we can write this as 6 into 10 raised to minus 5, and we can write this as mole per liter per second, like this. Three eights are 20, yes, remaining is 2, 3 C's are 18, remaining 2, we can make like this one. So to try to understand this question, very simple question but very important question, because precisely this type of question comes in your theory examination as well as in the entrance examination. So you just copy this part, you can pause video and you can copy also, or you might have written this, you know, I was explaining on the board. We have to go ahead because we have to solve so many questions. So I will go for next question. Again the reaction is given here. The reaction is 2A. 2A gives 4B plus C, and is carried out in closed vessel, closed container, the concentration, I'm writing this in short, concentration of B is found to increase, yes, it is appearing because this product found to increase 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 mole per liter in 10 seconds, in 10 seconds. This is not the rate of reaction, this is unit of concentration, and this is time. We know the how to calculate that. Calculate 3 things we have to calculate. First is the rate of appearance of B. Rate of appearance of B The next is rate of reaction itself. Rate of reaction. And third is rate of disappearance of A. Rate of disappearance of A. So these are the terms which you have to calculate. You can use that data and you can calculate it. Now first is, this equation is given. We'll express the rate of reaction in terms of all the reactant and product. That should be the first step we should do, because three terms we have to calculate. So we can write this as 1 by 2. Remember this 1 by 2. I'm writing from this 2, which is the stoichiometric coefficient of A. This is nothing but rate of disappearance of A. Then this is product 1 by 4. Again, this 4, where, from where I have taken, this 4 is stoichiometric coefficient. This is rate of appearance of B, rate of formation of B, rate of production of B. And DC by delta C by delta T, rate of formation of C. This we have written from the rate of reaction. Now concentration of B is found to increase. Of course, it will increase in the due course of time because B is product. And in 10 seconds, some concentration increase they have given. So, what we have to calculate by using this data, delta B is nothing but increase in concentration of B, and that is in the given time. So, this we can calculate by using these two values here. 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 mole per liter by 10 equals to 5 into 10 raised to minus 4. I will write this. And that I will write here as mole per liter per second. So this is the rate of appearance of B, rate of formation of B. Calculate what is the rate of appearance of B. This, yes, we have already, I think we have answered this question. It is this much, 5 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per second. Now another question is, what is the rate of reaction? Whether the rate of reaction is equal to rate of appearance of B? No. It would have been equal if it is number of moles here. In stoichiometric coefficient is 1, but this is not so. So it is 1 by 4 and this rate of appearance of B. 1 by 4 into 5 into 10 raised to minus 4. 1.25. into 10 raised to minus 4, and we can write it as mole per liter per second. Yes, these are the precise answers which we are calculating. So B also we have calculated. Rate of appearance of A, this term is rate of appearance of A. How we can calculate this? We can use the information of rate of appearance of B, or we can use the rate of reaction information, because already these two I have calculated. So in the C part I write negative, and this I am writing as rate of disappearance of A, that is equal to 2 by 4 half you can say, and this is rate of appearance of B. So this is 2 by 4 and rate of appearance of B is already we have calculated. 5 into 10 raised to minus 4. So this is 10 by 4 into 10 raised to minus 4. It is 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per second. So I have calculated part C also. So we can see this question once again. The concentration of B formed concentration divided by time. We first calculated the rate of appearance of B. Using that rate of appearance of B, we have calculated the rate of reaction, and again using the rate of appearance of B, we have calculated the rate of disappearance of the A. So very simple these questions, simple but already told you that important questions. Now we'll go ahead, because every question is different, we are taking, well, that's why we have to take more example. So look at the third question now. There is reaction, dinitrogen pentoxide, it has been dissociated to form 2 moles of nitrogen dioxide and half mole of oxygen, and rate of decomposition of dinitrogen pentoxide, rate of decomposition of dinitrogen pentoxide is 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 3 mole per liter per minute. What will be rate of formation of nitrogen dioxide and oxygen during the same interval? So once again the reaction is given, and rate of decomposition means rate of disappearance of dinitrogen pentoxide is given. So we can write rate of reaction is equal to, being the reactant it disappears, so we can write this as rate of disappearance or rate of decomposition here of nitrogen, dinitrogen pentoxide. We will write here 1 by 2 nitrogen dioxide. It was, coefficient was 2, I have written 1 by 2. Coefficient is 1 by 2. Now reciprocal of 1 by 2 is 2. So we can write 2 here. That's why this is the difference in this question. This is 1 by 2. 1 divided by 1 by 2, that becomes equal to 2. Only 2 we have written 1 by 2. What will be the rate of formation of nitrogen dioxide? They have given the rate of disappearance of dinitrogen pentoxide, and they have asked the rate of formation of nitrogen dioxide. Just transfer this 2 here. It is 2 times of that. We can easily make it out. So we can say rate of formation of nitrogen dioxide, rate of appearance of nitrogen dioxide, it's 2 times of rate of decomposition of dinitrogen pentoxide, which is 2 times of 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 3, which is I think 3.6 into 10 raised to minus 3, and that is mole per liter per minute. They are also asked the rate of formation of oxygen, so we can say again the same thing. We can calculate this by using the rate of formation of nitrogen dioxide which already you have calculated, or you can use this rate of decomposition of dinitrogen pentoxide. But that will be now divided. This 2 is here, so when it comes before this rate of disappearance, it is 1 by 2. So it is 1 by 2 rate of decomposition of dinitrogen pentoxide. It is 1 by 2 multiplied by 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 3. We can make it as 18 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 4 by 2. So we can write it as 9 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per minute. So again, same type of question, only there is difference in the stoichiometric coefficient. When it is 2, it is 1 by 2. When it is 1 by 2, reciprocal of 1 by 2, which is 2, we can write. So this is the third question. Now we can just go ahead and see the question number 4. In question number 4, we can now this is the solid example from our NCERT textbook, that is 4.2. Even though it is solid, I will just once again, as we are looking into this question first times, I will once again solve with you. The same reaction is given, only stoichiometric coefficient is different here. 4 moles of nitrogen dioxide and the oxygen. Initial concentration of dinitrogen pentoxide, initial concentration they are giving, it's 2.33 mole per liter, and after 184 minutes it is reduced to, yes, decreases, disappears, because it is a reactant, reduced to 2.08 mole per liter. Calculate average rate of reaction in terms of hours, minutes, and seconds. What is rate of production of NO2, nitrogen dioxide? What is rate of production of nitrogen dioxide? So this is the question before us. First we have to calculate the average rate, and we have to calculate the rate in three different units: mole per liter per minute, mole per liter per hour, mole per liter per second. And then we have to calculate the rate of production of nitrogen dioxide. So the first step is, we have to write the expression for rate of reaction. 1 by 2 disappearance of nitrogen, dinitrogen pentoxide. 1 by 4 rate of appearance of nitrogen dioxide and rate of appearance of oxygen. Yes, this we have written according to the expression. I hope that you are understanding this, how to express this rate. And they are asking us to calculate the average rate first. So we can say average rate is equal to negative of final reactant concentration, initial reactant concentration, final time minus initial time. I am writing this because they have given this concentration, final concentration and initial concentration. It was initial concentration, this is the initial concentration, and this is the final concentration. It has been decreased because it has been disappeared. So negative of 2.33 we have to subtract from it, and time period is 124. So if you calculate this, of course you can use simple calculator and get this answer as 6.79 into 10 raised to minus 4, and that we have calculated as mole per liter per minute. Not difficult calculation, you can do it. It will be negative because this number is smaller and this is larger, but that negative negative becomes positive and divided by 184. Calculation part is, we should not worry about it because they are simple numbers. Now we have done one unit, mole per liter per minute. They ask us to calculate mole per liter per hour and mole per liter per second also. So see here how we have to proceed. Our average we have calculated 6.79 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 4, and that unit is mole per liter per minute. So I'll divide it by minute. Now I have to convert this into per hour. So I have to convert these minutes into hours. We can use this dimensional analysis. We can write it here as 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. Why? Because minutes get cancelled and we will get the answer in per hour. So this minute, 1 minute, how many, 1 hour is equal to how many minutes? 60 minutes. So we have to arrange like this. So what number we are getting? 6.79 into 10 raised to minus 4 in mole per liter per minute. We have to multiply by 60, that is our answer. So I will again write this answer here. Again I am telling that this is not very complicated calculation, you can do yourself. Minus 2 mole per liter per hour, but you have to confirm it, mole per liter per hour. Then another one is the average rate. We have to calculate this in terms of now seconds. So 6.79 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per liter per minute. Now we have to convert that minutes into seconds. So we have to say that 1 minute equals to 60 seconds. So this minute we can cancel. That minute has been converted to seconds, so that we can get the answer in mole per liter per second. So basically multiplied by 60 you get mole per liter per hour, divided by 60 you get mole per liter per second. So I have again, I will write answer directly. It is 1.13 into 10 raised to minus 5 mole per liter per second. And Yes, one more question they asked. What is the rate of production of nitrogen dioxide? So we can say rate of production of nitrogen dioxide is equal to, yes, we can use this rate of reaction for it, or rate of disappearance of this reaction. So we can write here as 1 by 2, I should, even though answer is same, so it is 1 by 2, and then I will write this as, yes, well, I have missed this point, 1 by 2, because just coefficient of dinitrogen pentoxide was 2 here. You get same answer, I just missed that step, but you can verify it, you get the same answer. Now, nitrogen dioxide, we can say that it is equal to 4 into rate of reaction. 4 into rate of reaction, which already we have calculated, average rate we have calculated. So 4 into, we can substitute that 6.79 into 10 raised to minus 4, and that comes to be 2.72 into 10 raised to minus 3 mole per liter. And this, I use this data in per minute. So these are the four questions we have done. Now if you have NCERT textbook, I hope all of you have NCERT textbook, you can solve the in-text question. This is homework for you, that in-text question, it is not solved, you have to solve it, maybe tomorrow we will solve it. 4.1 and 4.2 and there is solved example 1 from NCERT textbook. I am giving this as the homework. But before concluding today's class, I will give one more question to you. We need to practice more, that is the thing here. If you practice more and more, then automatically you can solve any type of question. So I will write this, I am giving this as homework, this is not from NCERT. You can write this question and you solve it, definitely you will get answer. A drop of solution, there is a drop of solution which has volume 0.05 milliliter. It contains 3 into 10 raised to minus 6 mole of H plus ions. If the rate of disappearance of H plus ions is 1 into 10 raised to plus 7 mole per liter per second, how long, time they are asking, how long would it take for H plus ions in the drop to disappear. Yes, you can solve this question. I will not give any hint for this because you have to make it yourself. Definitely, we'll solve 4.1, 4.2, and this question in the next class. The solved example I will not solve once again because much data is given. You can solve yourself because some homework also is expected from you. Practice again and again. If you have any difficulty regarding this concept, you have my phone number in another platform, in that WhatsApp group which we have started. You can call me at any time, but don't this keep these doubts for longer period because you may forget what doubt you have afterwards. So better to solve it again and again, think over all these questions, and most importantly the CET material which provided from college. You can read questions and say okay, you can solve those questions. There is no need that we will complete this complete lesson and then we will start, because some introductory part we have done and so many questions are there on this part. So you can solve these questions, study regularly, and as I have told you, you are free to ask any doubt. Okay, thank you.